One of the things that is easily adjustable is your shifter. If you have boots that are really deep and thick, such as these Herman Survivors, okay, you are going to have to need a lot of space underneath. If you are coming across and you're always hitting, then this needs to come up. If you have too much space where you find up having to flex your foot back really far, then this needs to go down. What you need to find is this the right amount to where you're comfortable. And it's not just shifting up, it's shifting down. Think about it, all right? Do you wanna have your foot all the way like this in order to shift down? So this is a balancing act between where you can get your foot underneath here comfortably and where you can put it down on top comfortably. So the thicker and the deeper the boot, actually the worse it is. Now this is a pretty deep boot if you take a look at it, all right? From here to here is pretty damn deep, okay? So right now, and it's also a wide boot, so this is just about right for me, all right? This is one of the sets of boots that I wear. If I change boots that are significantly narrower and I'm gonna be on a long trip, well then I'm gonna have to make an adjustment. So what we wanna key in on is how do we adjust this? You're gonna see right now just how simple it really is. Okay, so before we get started, sometimes your foot is normally seated like this, depending upon where your knees are. Again, I just want to remind you that this may vary based on your riding position. If you ride like this, you're in great shape. If you ride like this, well, then maybe you want to bring it down. But just remember, you're going to have to slide your foot in no matter how you do it. And you don't want to get to where it's uncomfortable. But again, this is a really, really simple adjustment. So let's take a look. Well, look how simple this is. The fulcrum is right here where your peg is. And then this drives this rod right here. Now this particular rod, it's regular threaded on this side and it's reverse threaded on this side. So when you loosen the jam nut here and the jam nut here, what happens is you just rotate this and it'll either pull it in equally or pull it apart equally, all right? And that'll make an adjustment. So let me show you how that works right now. You're going to need two wrenches. You can use a 12 millimeter and a 13 millimeter, or you can use a 7/16 and a half inch. Either one will work. In this case, I'm gonna use a 12 to hold this swivel head in place. And then to break the jam nut, I'm gonna use the 13 millimeter. Now, lefty loosey, righty tighty, okay? Look at the jam nut, all right? It's regular threaded, okay? So all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna back this up all the way so that I have room to play with it, okay? And then let's look at the rear nut. All right, when we come to the back, it's gonna be changed up a little bit, okay? I'm gonna put my 12 millimeter here to hold it back. Now normally, I would pull the wrench down to tighten it, but in this case, since this is reverse threads, I'm actually gonna pull it down to break it loose. All right, so look at this. See, so I'm just gonna back this up all the way. Simple. Because the front is regular thread and the rear is reverse threaded, now when I go to adjust this, they're gonna spread apart or come together all the way. All right, that's as far as actually that goes, believe it or not, as far as in. You gotta watch this way because you don't want it to pop out, okay? So if I crank it all the way it's actually going in and in, even though I'm tightening it to go in this way, the reverse is going the opposite. So you're just gonna adjust this back and forth until you find the right height. Let's take a look at what's happening while I turn this. As I turn the rod to loosen it, it raises it. And if I think about just the front and I spin it to drop it, it drops down. So now I know this is as low as this can go right here. And that's pretty low, because if you look at this boot now, now I have to come in at an angle just to get underneath it. Boy, that's really low. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it back where it was for me. All right, I'm gonna spin it outward, put this at a slight angle down. All right, see, I can go up, I can go down too far, or I'm gonna make it just right so I know I can get it in there and I have a little bit of play. All right, that's where I want mine. Now what you have to do is take it off, or sit on the bike actually, and just go through the motions and see how it feels to you and make an adjustment. That's the best thing to do, is get on and off the bike. Now that you have it where you want it, hold this rod steady, do the reverse, snug it up, do the forward, snug it up. If you want, you can throw on a little bit of blue Loctite. That might be a good idea to hold it in place. Put your 12 millimeter over here on this swivel head, all right? And then just tighten it down, okay? You don't have to go crazy with it. And then come to the back and do the same thing. Put the 12 here, but remember, you think you're loosening it, but you're actually tightening it. So, boom, there you go. All good to go. We have the proper height we need. Quite simple, isn't it? I hope you enjoyed this.